Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco, and today I'm going to be talking about translucency. But mainly what I'm going to be talking about is the misconception that people always say that translucency is a fake subsurface scattering, and in general people always say just if you need subsurface, don't use it because it renders for ages, just use translucency, it's good enough, etc, etc. But the kind of the reaction on what exactly translucency does versus subsurface scattering is similar but very, very different. Now, I'm gonna have three examples. One is gonna be with two boxes, two Stanford dragons, and two candles. So let's start with the boxes. As you can see, on the left we're gonna have the translucency box, on the right we're gonna have the subsurface one. So I have two lights, and these lights are just instances, and they're hitting at the boxes. And I'm gonna have this, you see like this green box, that's like a divider, because I'm having two light sources, and I don't want it to interfere one with another, so I've placed a divider so that we can get a clear result. When it comes to material, I have, so this is my translucence material on the left, subsurface scattering material on the right. Just a quick introduction. For translucency, you always have some sort of slider for translucency to pick the color of translucency, and my translucency is on because it's set to 1. And for subsurface scattering, it's important that your refraction is turned on, and here in my F-Storm I need to just scroll down and there is a volume section, and here I need to enable scattering. Scattering is by default in black color, meaning it's turned off, but you know, I set it to white and now it's turned on. Apart from translucency, which generally just has the color texture input and the strength, with subsurface scattering you actually can define the distance, etc, etc. So let me fire up my render. Now, this is the render. The object on the box on the left is translucency, the box on the right is subsurface scattering, and they look pretty much the same. Now, you could agree that yeah, they are a little bit different, but you could agree that these look pretty similar, and you could agree that they are pretty much doing the same job. Now, just one note. The lights that I'm using here, you can kind of see that the lights are fading the more I go under an angle. That's because I have directional lights. So my light doesn't scatter light at 180 degrees. It has a focused beam light that's hitting the boxes. And because of that, you can actually see that on the subsurface one, you have a clear projection of the, you know, kind of rectangular box here. But on the translucent it is square-ish. But not quite, and that's the key difference. Now let's do our first test. So I'm gonna drop my maximum ray bounces. So in F-Storm that's max depth, so how many rays are gonna be bounced around in the scene. So I'm gonna set that to 1, and look what happens. Subsurface scattering got noticeably darker, where translucency didn't actually change. Now take a look at this. If I set my ray bounces or max depth to 16, translucency barely moved. That's one of the reasons why it's very fast. So that first bounce will actually do the trick. But okay, let's go to bounce 1. Now look at this. I'm gonna rotate my camera and get this. Backsides of both are black, which is logical because light traveled through both of them, and that's fine. Now, if I set my max depth to number 2, look what happened. Translucency on the right is still black, but the subsurface scattering got this light element here. And just again, this is not a... I know it kind of looks like a reflection. It's not a reflection, it's focused light, and that's how it looks like. But the subsurface scattered one, you can actually see the light at the front. For translucency, you don't. So okay, so let's increase max depth. Let's set it to 8. Subsurface got brighter. Translucency is still dark. And now when I rotate it on the whole thing on the other side, they still look pretty much the same. It's just that the translucency, when the light hits it, the light is being ignored. But okay, let's proceed with our testings. So I'm gonna increase the thickness of these boxes. So let's put the thickness to, let's say, 30 centimeters. You know, they always say never use translucency on complex objects or thick objects. Let's see why. So my subsurface scattering value is actually very low here. So let me just go to my subsurface scatter box. I'm gonna set my volume to be, I don't know, five centimeters. One of the first things that you can notice here is that the rays in the subsurface, they went through the object and they never reached the end. Well, with the translucency, you can see that the rays are kind of traveling here and it's getting darker, and then suddenly the backside is completely bright. So this is what is happening. With subsurface scattering, when a light hits an object, the rays are gonna enter the object and they're gonna scatter around subsurface. They're gonna scatter around and then they're gonna exit in whichever way they wanna exit. And that is the main reason why that first bounce that we saw, the rays entered, you did not see them on this side where the light hits, but on the second bounce, they returned. With translucency, nothing bounces. If you have a thick object and you shine a light on it, the light rays are not gonna enter the object, they're not gonna scatter around, they're gonna be projected on the other side, like teleported, magic. So, light is gonna hit the translucent surface, it's literally gonna be ignored because it got into another dimension, and it's gonna be teleported on the other side in a much blurrier form. And that's what actually translucency does, and that's the purpose. That's why people use translucency on very thin objects. So translucency is used when you do not care how the light on the other side will look. For example, leaves, curtains, paper, or some thin objects. And when the subsurface scattering enters an object, it's actually calculating the rays and bounces and calculating, and that's why it takes so long to render and then it exits, etc., etc. Look at this, even when I turn it back, like you can see the subsurface has light, this is completely black. So yeah, it's a little bit mind-bending, if I can say. Now, let's go to our Stanford dragons. So I got our two dragons here. And you can see, like you can clearly see, that the subsurface scattered dragon kind of looks logical. You can really feel that depth coming through him. But the translucency one does not look nothing like this. It looks completely weird. Not only that, look, I'm gonna rotate my, by the way, my lights are hidden, just so that, because what I rotated that you can see, but they are here, look, lights. Okay. On the other side, look at this. You can feel like that first contact definition of the light on the surface of the dragon, but here we are seeing that ignored light. Now, when you think about it, what is the actual purpose of this? You can actually come to one conclusion. If you have an ability in your software, which is called translucency, that when the light hits an object, it gets ignored, but it's actually teleported on the other side. There's no material in the world that does that, like real material in the world that does that effect. And because of that, I came to a conclusion that translucency was never intended to be used solo, 100% alone, because this is an add-on. This is not a full material. This is literally an effect that you have to apply to something solid, something that you can quote unquote, touch. So what does that also mean? Why is it black in the first place? Well, if I click on my translucency material, it's black because when translucency is on at a 100%, it's completely ignoring the diffuse. And if the diffuse is ignored, the color of the diffuse is black. And that's why you see the black color. But if I lower my translucency, the white color of the diffuse will start to kick in. And now take a look at this. So, with the real subsurface scattering, you know, kind of thing happening here, you can see that you have the brightest part on the front. And of course, on the back, you see those darker elements. Well, those darker elements, that's the intensity of the translucency that I'm trying to get that's gonna give me a realistic result. Although this is a complex object, it has to be subsurface scattering, but bear with me. So look at this, going at the front, and I'm gonna start reducing my translucency. So take a look at this. Translucency is 0.67. These two look very, very similar now. The point is, that front, where it's missing the light, you have to fill it with the diffuse color to simulate the light hitting it. So, translucency is an add-on. It's not a solo material. It has to be combined with the diffuse. Otherwise, it's gonna look like crap. So now, if I rotate my dragons on a side, you can actually see that these two actually feel very similar now. See what I mean? Translucency was never used to be used alone. It has to be compensated with the diffuse color. Let's move to our candles. So I have two candles here, and I'm just gonna actually hide the floor for now. So I got two candles. And these are my two candle materials. So left translucency, right subsurface scattering. And look at this. Translucency, you have those weird dark elements happening here, where with subsurface scattering, it just nicely flows. And now, you can try to compensate diffuse color to kind of fill the gaps with the translucency, and it is gonna somehow work. You see, like this. It kinda looks similar, not quite, but kinda. But don't take this as a solid solution, because still, look at this. If I rotate my camera to the bottom, so the translucency next to subsurface, you are still gonna get that same fake result. You're gonna get that the bottom will be lighter, and with the subsurface, it's actually gonna be, you know, realistically darker. So yeah, keep in mind, when translucency hits an object, the light is not gonna be visible. It's only gonna be visible on the opposite side, and that's when you need to compensate that front with the diffuse color. Of course, you can keep the translucency at 100%, and if you're using some texture plugged to it, and that texture has some gray elements, it is gonna work properly. But yeah, I just wanted to do this kind of little tutorial just to kind of distinguish the real differences between subsurface scattering and translucency, and how they are not actually the same and they have different purpose and different behaviors. So yeah, translucency used on thin objects, curtains, papers, whatever, but subsurface scattering, thick objects, complex objects, otherwise you're gonna get a crappy result. And as usual, don't forget to check EverMotion's website. Arc interiors for Unreal Engine Volume 12 art galleries are 25% off. There are new tutorials updated. Look, even my curtain tutorial and outdoor lighting in 3D, is there a magic formula? I guess if you read this, you will find the magic formula in other articles here. Of course, go to shop if you're interested in buying some objects. If not, hang around, send, you know, click on the contact, send the EverMotion guys a message saying, hi, you're cool, RenderRam sent me, whatever. And yeah, that's it. See you in the next video. Bye.